Well, it was a beautiful weekend, especially on the Sunday, for our karaoke cruise. The annual karaoke cruise, a great success. Thanks to everybody who came out and enjoyed themselves singing and dancing, and always good times on the Duke d'Orleans. And I want to say thank you to our friends at the Duke d'Orleans, always looking after us, very professional and courteous there. And if you're looking for some fun, check out their website at DukeD'Orleans.com. They've always got entertainment on there and lunch cruises. It's just always a really good time. So thanks to them. And I also want to say thank you to my friend Stephanie Purdy from Purdy Ideal Youth Center. We had some prizes donated by her to give away on our cruise as well. So thank you so much, Stephanie, for that. It's already marked down for next year, August the 12th, so save the date, and hopefully you'll join us this time. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show this week. It's episode 302. What's your world like? How about a virtual world? There's a virtual reality arcade coming to Sarnia. Our friends down at District Beta are going to talk to us about it, and we're going to show you how some of that works as well. Let's go out to the entertainment scene and talk with Travis Kelly.
The entertainment scene is brought to you by Body Moves. Visit them online at bodymoves.ca.
Well, I remember the days of Pac-Man and Galaxy and Space Invaders. In fact, I still like playing those games. But some really cool stuff happened. Now the virtual reality world is taken over by storm, and now it's going to be taken over out here in the Valley Axe location out here on the Golden Mile. And it's called District Beta, and one of the co-owners here, Travis Kelly. Thanks for being here, Travis.
Thanks for having me out.
You're welcome. This is exciting, you know, because this is something new to this area, and you got quite a really cool computer running all this stuff. Talk about what's behind us here.
Yeah, so behind us here, we got a booth set up. This is just our trial booth for the month of August before we open our actual location. We got it set up with a very high-powered computer and then a virtual reality headset, so you can come in, give it a try, try out some all the different virtual reality games and experiences, and just get into it.
Yeah, right on. What kind of different games, like, are we talking about different? Are we shooting people? Or are we throwing things? What's going on?
So we got all sorts of games. We got art games. We got first-person shooter games. We got archery games. We got everything. There's zombie games, every kind of aspect of games. But there's also experiences where you can, like, go around Mars, go deep-sea diving, ride on roller coasters, all sorts of stuff.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
So for somebody who just wants to come in, you don't even have to do anything. Just put it on and go for a ride.
Yeah, just put it on and just experience it. Just look around, see what all they have to offer.
Yeah, okay. What made you decide, like, this is going to be something that we should bring out here and have some fun with? You'd been somewhere else, maybe saw this, and thought, yeah, we need to bring that to Sarnia.
Yeah, I tried it out earlier in the year, about April, May. I tried it out in Guelph at a virtual reality arcade there with a couple of friends, and I really enjoyed it. Came back, decided to talk to Bo here at Valley Axe, decided that we need to bring something like this to Sarnia.
Yeah, okay. Do you have a favorite game?
So far, my favorite game is one of the archery games. There's a couple different ones, but my favorite one's Quiver. It's an archery game where you're up on cliffs shooting down on people. They come in waves at you.
Right, sounds good. Well, there's only one way to really figure it out. We're going to give you a demonstration right now, and actually then you really need to just come out here and check it out. Take a look at this real quick.
I'm Trevor. I'm with the Work From Home Corps. Ah!
Well, there you go. A great demonstration of the virtual reality that's out here. And now, Travis, tell us, how do they get out here to play and how much is it, all that stuff?
So we're open here for the month of August. We're here in Valley Axe. You can come out and give it a shot. And then we're open upstairs September 1st, Labor Day weekend. We're going to have a bunch more booths set up so you can come in. And what we're charging is $30 per hour, so 50 cents a minute. You can come in, you can book it for an hour, you can book it for five. Do whatever you want. You can share the booth with some friends. Recommend if you're sharing, no more than three friends. But then, yeah, you can come out, give it a shot.
All right, sounds good. Travis, thank you so much. And I think I might give this a try as well. Come on out here, check out District Beta out here on the Golden Mile in the Valley Axe location. virtual reality. Well, it's a reality here in Sarnia now. District Beta is located out at the Valley Axe location on the Golden Mile, and Travis wants you to come out and have some fun. I didn't get a chance to try it out that time. That was my son Jason. It was quite entertaining to watch him play, but I have been invited back, and I think I'm going to do some Spider-Man when we're out there. The best way to find them, go onto their Facebook page at District Beta. They got all the prices and all the times that they're available out there. And of course, as Travis said, they will be open upstairs Labor Day weekend. So looking forward to that. Thanks, Travis, and looking forward to some Spider-Man next time. All right. Well, out in the community, who doesn't like a good movie? And isn't it fun to do it outside? The outdoor movie nights are really popular. And that's why Libro is putting on one here in Sarnia. They love giving back to their community. And movie night is coming up August 22nd with them. We're going to talk to Dan Genovy right now. Take a look.
This community segment is brought to you by AG Event Graphics. Visit their website at askguy.ca.
We're talking community and entertainment this week, and our friends at Libro constantly giving back into the community, and financial services representative Dan Genovy's here today. Thanks for being here, Dan.
Thanks for having me, Dave.
This is an annual event that has become quite popular with Libro, Movie Night.
It is. The 7th annual outdoor movie night, August 22nd, Tuesday night, here at Canatara. Starts at 6:30. We're going to be showing Moana. We got a bunch of other activities going on for the kids that day as well.
Oh, yeah. What kind of activities?
We have some face painters coming, some balloon twisters. We're going to have one of those inflatable bouncy castles going on over here in the park. So, yeah, it should be a good time.
So bring the family out and have a good time.
Absolutely.
And Libro and community, those two words seem to go together often. Libro has a strong presence in their communities.
Yes, Libro definitely strong community values for sure when it comes to doing events in the communities that we work in, and that's what we love to do. So
What's different? Let's talk a minute about what Libro is, like compared to the bank.
Well, we're a full service financial institution, so that means we offer just about everything a bank does, and even a little bit more. The only difference is our ownership structure, really. Banks are owned by shareholders, we're owned by our members, and our owners are our members. So, they open an account, they put in membership shares, and they own a piece of Libro. So,
what a great concept, right? And having being a part of something that's community-oriented as well.
Exactly.
Fantastic. That's right.
Exactly. Yep.
So there's no cost for this? People just come on out and have a good time?
Yep, free of charge. Libro's covering everything. We're going to have some free popcorn as well that night. The CUA Kiwanis are going to be coming out and helping us out with that as well. So, it's going to be a great time.
All right, sounds good. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for sharing that with us, Dan Genovy. We appreciate that. Libro, once again, giving back to our community here in Sarnia Lambton. And you're invited. Doesn't matter what age you are. Just come on out here on August the 22nd. Enjoy a movie night on behalf of Libro. Movie nights are always a lot of fun. They're even better when you can get outside and enjoy them in one of our beautiful parks. Canatara Park, August the 22nd, Libro Movie Night, another great way that Libro continues to give back into our community. And Dan Genovy there inviting all of you to come out, get your lawn chairs and have some popcorn and enjoy another great night down at Canatara Park for Libro Movie Night, again, August the 22nd. Thanks for the invite, Dan, and we'll look for you down there for sure. Well, speaking of parks, we have a lot of beautiful parks here in Sarnia Lambton, and Centennial Park opened once again, and it's beautiful down there along the water. ARTZscape by the Bay 2017 is happening this Saturday and Sunday, August 19th and 20th. Beautiful and elegant art pieces down there. There's going to be stuff for the kids as well, so bring the kids on down, enjoy some of that, and go for a nice walk all the way down on the Sarnia Bay. And of course, there's going to be a licensed area there for the big kids as well, and it's just going to be a fantastic time. And of course, there's going to be entertainment down there as well. Gypsy Flats will be kicking that off. Mike Blackmore is going to be down there, the Blue Water Corpsmen. There's a whole lineup of things to do Saturday and Sunday. Once again, down at ARTZscape by the Bay 2017. I'll be there all weekend doing some live broadcasting, likely have some things to give away as well. So get out this weekend. It's looking to be a beautiful weekend weather-wise as well. So ARTZscape by the Bay 2017. We'll hope to see you down for that. And then moving on in a couple weeks' time, coming up, yes, there's two Ribfests now. At Northern Heat Ribfest is coming back to Hiawatha, and that's going to be happening Labor Day weekend. Again, I'll be down at that event as well, and I'm going to be giving away some free food and stuff on our Facebook page and down there, and we'll have some special interviews about what's happening at the Northern Heat Rib Series, Sarnia Ribfest, and craft beer is going to be there as well at Hiawatha on Labor Day weekend. So there you go. Some things to mark down on your calendar, and as I always like to say, that's all the time I got for you this week. Have a great week and an even better weekend. And we'll see you next time right here on the show. Bye-bye for now.